MUKnightsTV catching up with the Marian football program and head coach Mark Henninger as the Knights have reported back for camp, report for class, 2 weeks in practice done. Coach, it's January. We're still practicing football, but we're practicing for the season. How the first 2 weeks kind of gone here as you guys are getting ready for a February 13th kickoff?
Yeah, I'm really pleased with our first 2 weeks of practice. I mean, we've done, I think if you really step back and look at it, you know, where we kind of hope to see our team, be at this point in the season, I think that our guys have done a great job. I feel like we're where we should be. Now, we're a long way away from where we need to be, come week one. But I think for this point, I'm really pleased. I feel like, the steps, the strides that we made in the fall, I feel like we've been able to kind of get through our install a lot faster. I mean, I think our guys definitely retain stuff. You can tell that they, once our fall season ended and our guys got in the weight room and I mean there's no question we're I think we are a better football team today than we were in October. Our guys have worked really hard and they've handled all of the adversity, all the distractions, all the stuff that that we've had to deal with, that a football team this year has to deal with that they normally don't have to deal with, and so really pleased with where we are right now.
I was going to say, this season there's going to be a lot of adversity, whether it be, not knowing if you're going to play, who's going to be at practice. It's obviously a challenge for the coaching staff, but one thing that you have to love is you kind of hit there, having practice in the fall, and you guys have a lot of young players on this team. How huge was that to develop them, to get them ready for this season?
It's really big. I think we're going to end up with players playing this spring that if our season was in the fall, those guys probably wouldn't have been ready to play. I mean, I think we've got some young guys that, some freshmen that have come in that, now where they are right now, walking into practice number one versus where they were practice one in the fall, completely different, So it definitely changes the dynamics a little bit of the way the football team operates. But at the end of the day, it's all about competition and who's producing and our guys have been very, very competitive here this last 2 weeks.
And Coach, that's one thing, with this team, you have a lot of leadership coming back. It's been a while since we've seen the Knights play. December 21st, 2019 was the last time. You lost a lot of leaders in Charles Salary, Tyler Lotz, Mac Dutra, and Nakai Poyser. But you still have some key players left from that team, TJ Comer, Johnny Williams. Kind of talk about those upperclassmen and their leadership and what they've brought to this team in developing you guys to get ready for February 13th.
Yeah, every football season, I mean, this is a guy that used to play. I mean, every football season brings about new challenges. I mean, it is a... every year it's a completely different team. You have to get, even though you have a lot of, there's a lot of familiar names, from one year to the next, how do those teams gel? How does the leadership, step front and take charge? And then obviously how do you account for the loss in leadership? And so, I couldn't be happier really with, the guys you mentioned, Riley Pease, TJ Comer, Johnny William, Greg Miller, over on the offensive side and Cam Harris, Chris Oakley. I mean, we've got a really great senior class right now and a lot of guys that really, they've played important minutes of football here. But the thing that I'm really so impressed with this group is that, the focus and the emphasis really ever since they made the decision to cancel our season in the fall really going all the way back to the spring when the pandemic first hit and schools shut down those guys that we're looking to for great leadership have really provided it. They've really focused on controlling what they can control, and that's their effort and their attitude, and those guys have really, every chance that we get the opportunity to go out on the football field right now and compete, it's almost like they really relish in that opportunity because they know that there's no guarantee for tomorrow. So, I couldn't be happier really with the leadership that we're getting right now to these guys. I mean, an incredibly difficult position for them to be in with so many unknowns. But you go out and watch us practice, you wouldn't know it. You go watch our guys, the way they handle themselves in meetings and they're excited for the opportunity to compete. And, if that's a traditional we'll play in October or if it means we're going to open up and play February 13th, they're just excited to have the opportunity. And again, you can't have a great football team without great leadership. Those guys have really done a fantastic job of leading.
Hey, Coach, we want to thank you for your time. We'll check back in with you here in about less than 2 weeks. Signing day is right around the corner.
Yeah.
We'll get to see who the new class of Knights are right. Before we even see the current class of Knights play. So that'll be a fun time for the Knights. Look forward to a report here in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's been great to be able to handle all the different balls in the air of recruiting and signing day and opening day and all that. So we're excited about having the opportunity.
Awesome. Thanks for your time, Coach.
Thanks, Mitch.